Everyone, today we will be discussing about solving systems of linear equations using determinants under our subject algebra. So at the end of the presentation, the student should be able to solve systems of linear equations with two unknowns, three or more unknowns, no? So subtopics is of course solving two unknowns and three unknowns, and let's proceed to two unknowns in solving using determinants. So what is a determinant? So a determinant is a square array of numerals enclosed by vertical bars. So as you can see here, is the symbol in a determinant, no? So we have here a sub 1, a sub 2, b sub 1, and b sub 2. So the numbers a sub 1, a sub 2, b sub 1, and b sub 2 are called the entries or the elements of the determinant. So if it is enclosed in a vertical bar, so it is called a determinant, no? So in order to find the value of the determinant of order 2, which is defined as a sub 1 b sub 1 minus a sub 2 b sub 1. So here is the formulation for finding the determinant of order 2. So it is obtained by subtracting the product of the entries on the secondary. So this one, a sub 2 and b sub 2, you have to subtract it on the product of the entries of the principal diagonal, a sub 1 and b sub 2. So a sub 2 and b sub 2 subtracted from a sub 1, b sub 1, which is the principal diagonal of our determinant. So let's just consider the solution of a pair of general equations, a sub 1 x plus b sub 1 y is equivalent to a constant k1. A sub 2 x plus b sub 2 y is equivalent to k2 for x and y in terms of the coefficients. So this can be written in determinant form. So in order to find for the value of x on these systems of equations of two unknowns, as you can see here, we have just replaced the values of a1 and a2 with k1 and k2 in terms of the x part here, and then similarly on the value for y, we have replaced k1 and k2 on the coefficients of b1 and b2, no? And then all of them have the same denominator for the determinant. So the denominator for that is on the coefficients of x and y, a sub 1, b sub 1, a sub 2, and b sub 2. So in order to do the solution for the systems of the pair of general solution, so here is the formulation in determinant form. And then after that, we will be solving it in terms of determinant, no? So note that the system of linear equations has a solution that is unique if the determinant D is not equal to zero. So you need to first actually make it a point that the determinant is not equal to zero in order for us to do it in determinants, no? So, and if it is equal to if it is equal to zero, you may need to do a substitution or elimination method on our past discussions. So finding the solutions in determinant form is also referred to as Cramer's rule, no? In order for the Swiss mathematician Gabriel Cramer, no? So let us solve the sample problem number one. We have here given two simultaneous equations with two unknowns of 3x minus 2y is equivalent to 7, and 5x minus 3y is equivalent to 11. Now, to solve the systems of equation, let us transform first it into its determinant form. And as we have discussed lately, so in order to find the value of x, let's just substitute the constants of the main equation 7 and 11 on the coefficients, no? Coefficients of the value of x, which is 7 and 11 here, and then just copy negative 2 and minus 3 on this side, and then the denominator just removed actually, or not used the constant side of the equation, and just focus on the coefficients of x and y and put it on the, in this way. So 3 5 and a minus 2 and minus 3. And based on the rule in finding the determinant in 2, in order of 2, so subtract no the secondary part to the principal diagonal. So 11 minus 2, this one, subtracted to the principal diagonal, which is 7 multiplied by minus 3. You could also do 7 minus 3, no? Since we are going downward, you can actually do that one. Since downward, that will be negative. And then 11 multiplied by minus 2. No? And then over, same concept of the denominator side. 3 multiplied by 3 minus downward. No? And then 5 multiplied by minus 2. And then simplifying equates to 1. Same applies to the in determining the value of y. And in order to do that, just also replace the constants of our equations on the coefficients of y as shown here on the slide. No, so this one, 7 and 11, just replace it in 7 and 11 here. So 3 multiplied by 11 less 5 multiplied by 7, and then similarly to the denominator, same with the x, the value of x, the denominator for that. And then solving again, which equates to minus 2. So the solution for our systems of equation is x is equal to minus 1 and y is equal to negative 2. You can actually verify your answer by just substituting the values of x and y on your main equation. It should arrive to 7 with respect to the first equation, and with respect to the second equation, you can also substitute the values of x and y that arrives to 11 also. Also, you can verify it through our past lesson in substitution and elimination method. No? And let's proceed to the next part, subtopic for our main topic, which is three unknowns and or more unknowns in order to solve for the determinants. So Kramer's rules can actually be applied on n linear equations. So it can be three or more, no? Provided also again that the determinant of d, the coefficient, is not zero. No? So consider the following systems of equations. So the values of the unknowns are given as same as two on the concept of two unknowns. So x is equal to dx over d, y is equal to dy over d, and z is equal to d sub z over d. We are to find first the determinant for the denominator, which is given by the coefficients of the three equations. So a sub 1, b sub 1, c sub 1, and a sub 2, b sub 2, c sub 2 here, and then a sub 3, b sub 3, c sub 3 on this equation. And again, in order to find for the value of x on these three equations, just replace these, the coefficients in terms of x, to our constant value for our equation. So as you can see here on this slide, so k sub 1, k sub 2, k sub 3 has been replaced, no? And then similarly for the d sub y, you can see here it has been replaced, the coefficients of y. And then similarly to the z, is just replace the constant to the coefficient of z on our equation, no? So